Howdy, Mark here from Sharkbait, and I'm going to try and make this one a brief one. Yeah, I just came back from a long range trip, so I'm a little scruffy about the edges. You know, been on a boat with a bunch of guys, wife's nowhere close. I can go ahead and get scruffy and not shave for a few days. We'll see if I beard out during the wintertime. Any event, now one of the things I did on this particular charter, which was down at Guadalupe on, one of my favorite boats in the long range fleet, if not the favorite, the Red Rooster 3. We went to Guadalupe Island, which is the destination known for great white sharks and for catching good sized tuna and yellowtail. That's a whole nother video. Yeah, I'm trying to work on that one today as well. We'll see if I can get it done in the next couple of days and post it on a trip report. But the reason for this video is to talk Wahoo a little bit, and it's not going to be a whole Wahoo presentation, which I need to do, because we've got some specifics and this is the time of year to talk Wahoo. But it's to introduce you all to a new lure. And the reason I go to ICAST and spend the bucks to go there and stay at a fancy hotel in Orlando, and this time I took the wife and the kid, that sort of thing. But the reason I go is because I always find something new. Just by walking the floor. And this time, walking through the show, I saw a familiar face, a client of ours for years. He's been involved as a pro staffer for a few different products. I've known him, met him up when we were doing the expo up in Sacramento with Torretamer and Sharkbait. In any event, he was working a booth, which surprised me, and it was a booth I'd never heard of the company before. Meg Bay Lures, call me ignorant. They had quite a nice range of product. But one thing really caught my eye, which is the MagTrak 10, which is this lure. And this is, it's a planing type head. Now, let me see if I can zoom in a little bit on it or move closer so you can see a little better. But it uses a planing head. And by that, the shape of the head and the attachment point provides the depth. Now this lure is made by a very, very strong ABS material. Internally it's weighted, has a heavy weight on the front side, and then it incorporates, and my God, help me on this one, nemidium magnets on the inside. And so what happens on most lures of this style, this free floating hook, the stinger, scars up the side of the lure something fierce. And on these hollow bodied compressed foam lures, like our Marauders and the Bonitas and that sort of thing, you scar up the side and you can wind up having some water intrusion, some cosmetic issues, whatever. Not a great thing. And while those type of lures maintain a trolling type of head or a planing head, this one is unique in that it is so skinny. And it's small. It's a 10-inch lure, so I guess it's not small. But in terms of width, it's small for the size of the planing head. And that's what I really wanted to check out to see how stable this thing was on the troll. I got to tell you, this thing was rock stable, rock hard. You put it out there and it stayed. If you put it out in trolling position number one, she stayed number one. Put her in three, stayed in three. It did not shift. And some of these lures do. They redesignate their troll location by virtue of how they don't drag straight. This thing just trolled straight on the money. Just dandy in that respect. The hooks are appropriate and super, super sharp. You're not gonna be replacing these hooks, 400 pound swivels, ball bearing swivels on the thing. And as I mentioned, it has a magnet. And what that magnet does, keeps the hook where it's supposed to. Keeps it in place. So when a Wahoo comes up, and more often than not, they're coming from the front side on the thing, they hook it. And that hook will freely swing and do exactly what she's supposed to do. A lot of the cost of this lure actually is in the magnetic system. And I'll go one step that the manufacturer doesn't mention is that there are many predatory fish that make use of basically magnetic sensing, and that's one of the things they use to help target in. Now, I'm not sure on Wahoo if they incorporate that. I know Mako sharks certainly do, and I would not be surprised if a Wahoo did too. Certainly Wahoo does it. It takes care of the speed. These things will troll up to 20 knots. 20. That's double expected, And while some lures, well, let's say DTX minnows from Nomad, great stinking lure for getting bit. Yeah, they just are. Yeah, the reality is you can get bit on those things, and they can be a one and done lure. You know, one good fish, you get a tweak on the back end or a deck hand, you know, it takes a pair of dykes to pop it out like they did on one of my lures, it's done. You're not going to troll it anymore. It's not going to stay in the water. You know, these things you can hook up with a standard McMahon rig, let's say, like this guy, like this trolling harness that comes with a snap on the front side. You can clip that on, which is like what we used to do with Marauders, or what we still do with a Marauder lure. You know, you can't do that on a DTX. But you can rig these on the standard cable type of harness, and they're gonna track just fine. They don't have any issue with that. And when I say they track just fine, the sucker just, it just stays right where you put her, has a nice tight wiggle to it, and they get bit, and you can retrieve the doggone things even with the boat going at speed, although you are working against a big planing head. And it is big. I mean, that's, you know, the length of that planing head is greater than it would be for a Marauder or a Bonita, you know, style lure. You know, and the diameter, the width is skinnier, so the effect of that planing head is greater. You know, it'll get more depth, and they come in weighing about 12.5 ounces, so it's not a light lure, you know, but it's a very effective troller, and the patterns are great. You know, like this black with the red, super. You know, that's a nice pattern. But they also bring us a beautiful gold mackerel stripe. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see the color patterns a little better. Yeah, there we go. So that's the gold and black. Gotta have a Dorado. Yeah, and this is the Dorado pattern. Again, just gorgeous finish on these things. Great eyes, and unlike the eyes on my old Marauder, this will not become a Cyclops nearly as fast. I'm sure it can still happen. They've got a pink, like a pink Mac, dandy color for Wahoo. This is, and I see this thing, it certainly meets my eye for, you know, the strong sunlight condition days. And of course, you gotta have a purple and black. They call this a Marlin pattern. Looks like a little Wahoo to me. But again, wonderful lures. They are not cheap, you know, understand that one. These are an expensive lure. They run about $90 a piece. You know, you can compare that to the Nomad DTXs at around 35. Your big Marauders may run, you know, $40 or so. Bonitas, you know, I don't know, $30-$40 in that sort of range. So they're going to be double, even triple, you know, the money of some other lures, but they're going to be more durable. You know, and I think they're going to get bit very well. We'll know that this year. You know, I've seen plenty of videos of these things taking Wahoo, you know, and there's no reason why they won't. But I tell you, from a trolling standpoint, if I have, if I was skippering a big sport fisher, I'd be going with these things over anything else on the market, even including the very, very effective DTX minnows, just because you can use them more. You can put them out there more often. They're not going to get tweaked and go into the junk pile. You know, you're going to be able to fish them hard repeatedly, and they're going to hold up. I think they're going to hold up very, very well over time. So that's the new lure. And it is from MagBait. Kind of a big footprint, big card on these things. But I tell you, great product. I think they nailed it on this one. They have some other stuff that's quite interesting. They'll call cowbells and some other trolling lures. But the pick of the litter for me anyway, was that MagTrak. That's a neat piece. That's a really, really neat piece. So if you can spare the change next time you head out on a Wahoo trip, get yourself one. Yeah, I think you're gonna like that lure an awful lot, and it's gonna hold up and catch a whole lot of fish for you before you need to replace it. And at that point, it becomes a very, very economical investment for a fishing. In any event, this is a brief one. I'll come back and do a full-blown Wahoo presentation here shortly. Hopefully that'll address everything from bombs to trolling pieces, to spinner jets, and you name it. But for now, it's the MagTrak. I think it's worth it. Thanks for watching. Mark out.